of control satellite to crash land on Earth. Yeah, that's terrifying. So the Chinese Tiangong-1 space station is said to break apart from Earth's atmosphere sometime between March 30th and April 2nd. This craft was placed for orbit back in September of 2011. The station was designed to be a testbed for robotic technologies. The activity it has been doing lays groundwork for a more permanent space station that the Chinese plan to launch in the near future. Back in May of 2017, the Chinese officials released their first report to the UN, saying that the space station stopped operating back on March 16, 2016. The craft has been able to maintain its structural integrity, but it's out of fuel and can no longer be controlled by teams on the ground. It now circles Earth at an altitude of 200 miles, and the station is experiencing significant drag as it brushes against the planet's denser outer atmosphere. Due to this happening, every day it is losing an altitude at a rate of about 2.5 miles. Eventually, the space station will reach an altitude of about 43 miles, and that's when it will make its return to Earth. Now, the really scary part is that if a piece of the space station does survive the descent, it's hard to know where exactly on the planet it will land. The space station is expected to break apart, and there's a possibility that fragments as heavy as 220 pounds will come crashing onto Earth. After looking into it, it's been discovered that every continent except Antarctica is a potential fall zone. It's predicted that once it's about 24 hours out, they will be able to have a better understanding of the re-entry time down to 3 hours. Luckily, the planet is mostly covered by the ocean, so the likelihood of any survivable pieces landing in the ocean is highly likely. So hopefully that will be what happened. But as always, we will keep you guys up to date on the story. Hello everyone and welcome back to LP. Thank you for joining me on this beautiful Friday. I'm Court McGinley. I hope all of you are having a wonderful day and happy Good Friday to all of those who celebrate. And for people taking part in Lent, it is over. For Lent, I gave up meat, so I guess now I can have meat again. Also, I want to say happy Easter to all of you celebrating this weekend. I hope you have a great time and let me know what you have planned down in those comments. I'm going to be spending time with my family, so I'm super excited for that. Also, this is the last time I will be seeing you guys for quite some time. I'm going on a girls' trip to Chicago. I leave on Wednesday and will be back on Sunday. So sadly, I will not be in next week's weekend video. But if you live in Chicago, let me know down in the comments. I'd love to meet you. Also, if you'd like to follow my Chicago journey, then make sure you follow me on Instagram at Court McGinley. I promise there will be many pictures taken of the bean. Super excited for that. All right, as you guys know, we have a lot of interesting news stories headed your way, so without further ado, let's get started. Next, so on Tuesday night, a fan favorite show called Roseanne returned to our TV screens. Viewers love that the Connor family returned after 20 years. And that was obvious by the 18.2 million people that tuned in. The episode ended up debuting to the second best ratings of any scripted TV episode all year. The first one being the post-Super Bowl episode of This Is Us, which earned 26.97 million viewers. One fan really stood out, and that was President Donald Trump, who called Roseanne Barr himself to congratulate her on her successful return. The White House secretary confirmed the call was made. The New York Times said that Trump was enthralled with Roseanne's huge ratings. The president also thanked Barr for her support. Did you guys catch the first episode back? If so, let me know what you thought about it down in the comments. Next, Disneyland is opening a real-life Pizza Planet. God, I love Disneyland. Starting in April, Red Rocket's Pizza Port in Disneyland will transform into Aliens Pizza Planet. This restaurant is expected to be heavily themed on the Pizza Planet restaurant from Toy Story. As for Toy Story Land at Disneyland, it's looking incredible and fans are super excited about the updates that the park has been releasing. I'm definitely going to have to make a trip to Disneyland once everything is set up. Next, Ryan Reynolds and Chris Evans agree to make a dying boy's final wish come true. These two actors are true real-life superheroes. This all started when Fox News journalist Shannon Bream tweeted this message on March 25th. Need your help, Twitterverse. Trying to help a young boy who is dying. He probably just has days and all he wants is a greeting from the Avengers. If you have a celeb connection, please let me know. Otherwise, could you please help out with a retweet? Thank you in advance. Within 5 hours of this tweet, Chris Evans responded by tweeting, "Happy to DM me," followed closely behind with a response from Ryan Reynolds tweeting, "I'm more of a reserve Avenger, but happy to help, DM me." After reading these tweets, Shannon was so overwhelmed with gratitude, she tweeted out, "Thank you everyone, major progress has been made because of you. A special assist coming from at Jake Tapper." I guess Twitter can be full of love when someone really needs it. Of course, the real hero in this story is Emilio, who is sadly facing what no young person should ever have to think about. Our thoughts go to Emilio and his family, and we hope this meeting puts a huge smile on his face. Next, it's that time of the week where I let you guys know what super cool, awesome movies are hitting box office this weekend. And we have Ready Player One, Isle of Dogs, and Tyler Perry's Acrimony. Let's start off with Ready Player One. This movie is rated PG and it's a sci-fi movie. This film is based based off of the best-selling book that has become a worldwide phenomenon. This movie was directed by Steven Spielberg, and in it you'll see Ty Sheridan, Olivia Cooke, Ben Mendelsohn, and T.J. Miller, among others. The story is set in 2045, and it follows Wade Watts on his search for an Easter egg in the worldwide virtual reality game. This discovery will lead him to inherit the game creator's fortune. Take a look.
I'm talking about actual life and death stuff.
The Oasis, the world's most important economic resource.
It's nothing less than a war.
Next, we have Isle of Dogs. This movie is rated PG and it's an adventure animation comedy movie. In it, you'll hear Bill Murray, Jeff Goldblum, Bob Balaban, Yoko Ono, Scarlett Johansson, and Frances McDormand, among others. This tells the story of Atari, a 12-year-old ward to corrupt Mayor Kobayashi. When all the canine pets of Mega Aki City are exiled to a vast garbage dump, Atari sets off alone and flies to Trash Island in search of his bodyguard dog, Spots. There, with the assistance of the pack of newly found friends, he begins an epic journey that will decide the fate and future of the entire species. Take a look.
Spots, Spots.
We get the idea. You're looking for your lost dog, Spots. Does anybody know him?
No.
And finally, we have Tyler Perry's Acrimony. This movie is rated 14A and it's a drama. In this movie, you'll see Tataji P. Henderson, Tika Sumpter, Adjiona Alexis, and Jasmine Simon, among others. This movie is directed, written, and co-produced by Tyler Perry. In this movie, we follow a faithful wife tired of standing by her devious husband. She is enraged when it becomes clear that she has been betrayed. Here's a peek at the trailer.
And you cheat.
I'm Diana, Robert's fiance.
And now is that time of the video where we answer guys' questions, so let's get started. Miriam Makuna asked, would you rather be on Landon Productions or be on your vlog channel? That is a tough one. I love reporting on cool, interesting news stories, and I love you guys. But some of you guys are over on my vlog channel anyway, which is called Court McGinley Vlogs, so please head over there and subscribe if you haven't already. Also, I love my channel because I can pretty much do whatever I want over there. And I get to do Vlogmas, which I really enjoy. But I can't pick, I love both. Next, Video 7 asked, what's your favorite movie? So I have three, and they are The Wizard of Oz, Stepmom, and The Greatest Showman. I also love all Disney movies. Next, Reflect Club asks, do you have a dog? If so, what's its name and what species of dog is it? Sadly, I don't have a dog at the moment. I can't wait to have one again though. My dogs growing up were Glacier, who is a black lab, and Chico, who is a Cocker Spaniel. And I love and miss both of them so much. Next, Kieran Mencias of Awesome asked, what's your favorite food? I love soup and seafood. Next, Humberto Garcia said, great video, keep up the good work. Thank you so much for your kind words. I will and I appreciate it. Well, there you go guys, that's all the questions and comments and news stories I have for you today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful long weekend, and I'll see all of you next week.